Welcome friends, have a discussion over the halides of the fifth year group elements. Halides are those compounds which are the chemical combination of fifth year group element with the halogen atom. That is, if I consider fifth year group element as M and halogen as X, these are the just chemical combination of fifth year group element with the halogen. That is, M is for A times, X is for B times. There are different varieties of halides. But out of these halides, as per the electronic configuration is concerned, there are two varieties of important oxidation states. One is +3 oxidation state and second one is +5 oxidation state. In +3 oxidation state, as being halogen is monovalent atom, not having ability to form any kind of pi bonds, it can form 3 sigma bonds, that is MX3 type of compounds can be possible, and these are said to be trihalides. In the same way, in case of +5 oxidation state, the fifth year group element can form 5 sigma bonds. 5 are possible with the 5 halogen atoms. Hence, MX5, that is pentahalides and the trihalides are possible. As you know, nitrogen is not having any kind of d orbitals. It just forms trihalides. It does not form any kind of pentahalides. Now, the list of trihalides and the list of pentahalides, followed by the important halides for the eligibility of discussion purpose of fifth year group elements is like this. Different varieties of trihalides, all elements forms trihalides. From fluorine to iodine, every element of the fifth year group, nitrogen with fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, similarly bismuth with fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, all varieties of halogens can be possible. That is, trihalides of all elements and all varieties of halogens are possible. All trihalides are possible with all elements, whereas pentahalides, that is 5 halogens combination, 5 halogen atoms chemical combination with the fifth year group elements, those are pentahalides, generally indicated by MX5. X stands for halogen atom. Fluorides, chlorides, bromides and iodides are there. As we know, nitrogen is not having d orbital, hence it can't promote the electron to the d orbital. Hence, it just shows only 3 as its valency, not as 5. So, therefore, there is no pentahalide for the nitrogen. Pentahalides are present for the remaining elements, that is for fluorine, that is for phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and the bismuth. And once again, from top to bottom, inert pair effect increases. The reluctance of lone pair of electron to participate in chemical combination, to participate in excitation, to involve in sigma bond formation with the others is very little. As a result of its little interest, it doesn't form pentahalides much with the all varieties of the halogens, all varieties of the halides. Only most electronegative halide atoms, when comes, they promote the lone pair of electron present in bismuth to excitation, bismuth to participate in excitation. As a result, with fluorine, bismuth forms the pentahalides. But with the other halogen atoms, it can't form any kind of pentahalides. Here we have almost all some 8 pentahalides are there in reports. Those pentahalides are listed here. Nitrogen, no pentahalide is there. Yes, phosphorus can form pentafluoride, pentachloride as well as pentabromide also. Arsenic forms fluorides and chlorides. Antimony also forms fluorides and the chlorides. Whereas bismuth forms only pentafluoride, not the other halides. The reason is already explained. Out of all chlorides are important, because remaining are having not that much importance because of their stability, because of their reactivity and some other reasons. Only chlorides are important, and out of these chlorides, nitrogen chloride is not that much important, because NCl3 is a liquid, yellow colored liquid, and it is unstable and it is explosive also. So, therefore, explosive related material is not taken as an important one. Because it is explosive, we can't expect much from that. And the remaining other important chlorides are phosphorus pentachloride and the phosphorus trichloride. These are the important things. Here we explain what are meant by halides and how many varieties of halides are there. What are those? Why some of them are missing? What is the reason? What are the important? Why phosphorus halides are important? And what are those? And those are phosphorus trichloride as well as the phosphorus pentachloride. Have a general discussion over the trihalides, then on the pentahalides, then in detail we will go for phosphorus trichloride as well as the phosphorus pentachloride. Yes, general discussion on the trihalides of the 50A group elements. The general formula is given by MX3. Whereas the structure and the hybridization related information, if we go, the N value is found to be group number of central metal atom plus number of monovalent atoms by 2, which is equal to 4, implies sp3 is the hybridization. Whereas here 3 monovalent atoms are there, hence the next one is lone pair of electrons, that is ab3e1 type, pyramidal is the geometry. Now the next point is covalent and ionic character present in case of the trihalides. See, trihalides are having oxidation number of central metal atom as +3. +3 is less covalent compared to +5. Whereas within the +3 also we are having all varieties of trihalides, from nitrogen to the bismuth, all varieties of halides like fluorides, chlorides, bromides and the iodides. Now we will expand the relations left to right like this, top to bottom like this. See here, from left to right, in any variety of the pentavalent, that is fifth group halogens, from left to right its covalent character increases, because here what happens is the fifth A group atom remains same, the size of anion increases. As the size of anion increases, the polarization power of cation and polarizability of anion both enhances. As a result, the reback of the electron density present on the anion is possible, which is the symbolism for the covalent character. So therefore, in any of the series, generally what happens is from left to right, covalent character increases. Compare it to nitrogen trifluoride, trichloride is more covalent. Compare it to trichloride, tribromide is more covalent. Compare it to tribromide, triiodide is more covalent. Similarly, from top to bottom in any of the halogen, that is NF3, similarly PF3, antimony, arsenic and the bismuth trifluoride, like this, from top to bottom, here what happens is the metallic character increases. Metallic nature is ionic in nature, so therefore the ionic nature of the halides is goes on increasing. So left to right covalent character increases, top to bottom ionic character increases. The most ionic is bismuth pentafluoride. It is highest ionic character out of all varieties of the trihalides. The bismuth pentafluoride is complete ionic and remaining all are having either covalent character or to certain extent of covalent character. Similarly here, bismuth related remaining halides, if we take bismuth trichloride, bismuth tribromide, are having partial covalent as well as partial ionic character. Except these two incidents, remaining all trihalides are covalent in nature. That we are writing here, left to right, covalent character increases, top to bottom, ionic character increases. Except bismuth trifluoride, all are covalent in nature. Whereas bismuth trichloride, bismuth tribromide, bismuth triiodide are having partial covalent as well as partial ionic character. Whereas in case of nitrogen trihalides, because nitrogen trihalides as well as the phosphorus trihalides are exclusive for our discussion. In case of nitrogen trihalides, nitrogen trifluoride to nitrogen triiodide, only nitrogen trifluoride is stable and it is eligible for the discussion. Remaining are unstable and also explosive in nature. Especially nitrogen trichloride is, it is in liquidating state, it is unstable and it is explosive in nature, hence it is not eligible for the discussion. Now why these of all trihalides except nitrogen trifluoride are explosive in nature is, the bond length increases. As the bond length increases, the stability of the trihalide goes on decreasing. Hence, except nitrogen trifluoride, all other nitrogen trihalides are explosives. Here we wrote the same, nitrogen trifluoride is stable, remaining are unstable and explosive because of large size difference of nitrogen as well as the halogen atom. The next one is the Lewis character of the trihalides. As for the Lewis is concerned, electron pair donation is one particular property, electron pair acceptance is another particular property. Here we can define that one as Lewis acidic character as well as the Lewis basic character. Lewis acid stands for electron pair acceptor. Now we are discussing acidic character. Lewis acid is that one which is an electron pair acceptor. To accept the electrons, vacant orbital is required. but nitrogen is not having any kind of vacant orbital. Hence, nitrogen halides are not acting as Lewis acids. Except to nitrogen halides, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, but not the bismuth, because bismuth is suffering from the inert pair effect. So bismuth is metal. It does not have ability to accept the lone pair of electrons when it is connected with the halogens. Thus, phosphorus halides, similarly arsenic halides and antimony halides are acting as Lewis acids. Whereas, thus we wrote the complete things, that is phosphorus, arsenic, antimony related fluorides and the chlorides are acting as Lewis acids. Whereas, to maintain higher Lewis acidity, higher electron deficiency is required. Higher deficiency of the electrons, that is higher accepting ability of the lone pairs, is possible if the 5th A group element is connected with the more electronegative halogen. The more electronegative halogens are once again fluorine and the chlorine. Hence, this Lewis acid character is present for trifluorides of the phosphorus and trichlorides of the phosphorus, followed by arsenic as well as the antimony. Whereas if I go for the order which is having higher Lewis acidic character, such kind of orders if we measure, it is found that we are having the 6 varieties of trihalides which are acting as Lewis acids. Out of these, some of them are fluorides, some of them are chlorides. Fluorides are having higher Lewis acidity compared to the corresponding chlorides of the 5th A group element, because fluorine is more electronegative atom. And within the same variety of the halides, different varieties of the 5th A group elements, if you take, that is phosphorus trifluoride, arsenic trifluoride, antimony trifluoride, halide atom is same, but the 5th A group element is differs. In that case, what happens is, whichever the more electronegative central 5th A group element containing trihalides are there, that is acting as more strong Lewis acid. Thus, here phosphorus trifluoride is more acidic than arsenic trifluoride, and arsenic trifluoride is more acidic than antimony trifluoride. Some of the examples for the Lewis acidic character, that is either they are accepting the lone pair of electrons, or they are connecting with the nucleophile like anion containing species. See, SbCl3 on reaction with the 2 Cl minus ions, it is converted to SbCl5 2 minus. SbF3 on reaction with the F minus, it is converted to SbF4 minus. Phosphorus trichloride on reaction with the 6 ammonia molecules, it forms an adduct PCl3 6 ammonia. Thus here it is connecting with the anion, it is connecting with the lone pair of electrons containing neutral species. Thus in every case, these trihalides are acting as lone pair acceptors. Hence these of all are known as what? Lewis acids. Yes, the basic character, that is electron pair donation ability, Lewis basic character, due to having of lone pair of electrons on the central atom, these nitrogen trihalides are also acting as Lewis bases. Whereas this Lewis basic character, what happens to the Lewis basic character in case of all varieties of trihalides, let us have a discussion. I listed out here all varieties of trihalides: nitrogen trifluoride to nitrogen triiodide, followed by bismuth trifluoride to bismuth triiodide. See, it is not having vacant d orbitals to promote the lone pair of electrons present on the nitrogen to the other orbitals. So lone pair of electron density is present most of its time in the one particular orbital, hence it is available for its donation. That is, electron density is high, it is not spreaded. Moreover, the size of nitrogen is small, implies what? Your electron density is available, the density of electron availability is high, and moreover it is present at one particular location. Due to these reasons, what happens is nitrogen halides are acting as good, otherwise strong Lewis bases compared to the others. So therefore, Lewis basic character from top to bottom implies what? Nitrogen halides, phosphorus halides, arsenic halides, antimony halides and the bismuth halides of any of the halogen, if we take, nitrogen maintains higher, whereas bismuth maintains the lower order. Suppose if I take the fluorine as the example, nitrogen fluorides are acting as strong Lewis bases compared to phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and the bismuth fluorides. Similarly, from left to right, see, left to right implies the 5th A group element is common, followed by different varieties of halogens are taken. That is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodide. Suppose if I take nitrogen, nitrogen fluoride to nitrogen triiodide. Here halogen atom maintains different electronegativities. Fluorine is more electronegative. As a result, fluorine is more electronegative. It withdraws the electron density present on nitrogen. As a result, electron density availability decreases. Thus, nitrogen trifluoride is weak Lewis bases compared to trichloride, tribromide and the triiodide. So therefore, highest Lewis basic character is present for nitrogen triiodide and the least value is present for the bismuth trifluoride. So therefore, this is highest value because it is nitrogen family and moreover it is connected with least electronegative halide. Whereas this is bismuth family, maintains least, followed by what? Fluorine more electronegative. Hence it is maintaining least electronegativity, that is highest electronegativity in place. Least electron pair donation ability is there. Hence it is least Lewis basic and it is most Lewis basic corresponding trihalide. Hydrolysis. Trihalides easily undergoes hydrolysis. Whereas one of the trihalide, that is nitrogen trifluoride, which does not undergo hydrolysis because the NF bond is strong bond compared to NO bond. Because fluorine is smaller atom compared to the oxygen. So therefore the bond length of NF is smaller, implies what? Bond strength is higher. Hence fluorine is not replaced by any of the OH minus. So therefore NF3 does not undergo any kind of hydrolysis. And remaining all other trihalides easily undergoes hydrolysis and produces the corresponding products. Products are not common, they are different from one another and the formed product is depends on the nature of the electronegativity atom. The more electronegative atom is gives one variety of compound and less electronegative atom gives the other variety of compound. Because we are having different varieties of atoms as per halogens are concerned. As per the 50A group elements are concerned, electronegativity varies between them. On behalf of this particular difference, the formed product will also differ. Yes, but the product formed will be different because it depends on the electronegativity. Out of all varieties of the trihalides, the important trihalides that we said in the beginning is chlorides. So let us go for the discussion of the chlorides. So chlorides of nitrogen, chlorides of phosphorus, similarly arsenic, antimony and the bismuth. We are having atoms like nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, electronegativity decreases. But with respect to the chlorine, if we look, nitrogen is having higher electronegativity and remaining all others are having lesser electronegativity. So therefore electronegativity with respect to the chlorine, if we look, yes, chlorine, compared to chlorine, nitrogen is having higher electronegativity and compared to chlorine, remaining all other maintaining lower electronegativity, and the order is nitrogen is greater than chlorine and is greater than phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. Bismuth is least, nitrogen is the highest. Yes. Whereas in hydrolysis, that is reaction with water, water is present in the form of H plus ions and the OH minus ions. So therefore here positive ion is H plus, negative ion is OH minus. This is acting as electrophile, this is acting as nucleophile. This electrophile will goes to the more electronegative atom, whereas this nucleophile will goes for the less electronegative atom. In that way, product formed will be different. So therefore, NCl3, when it undergoes hydrolysis, nitrogen is having partial negative charge and chlorine is having partial positive charge, and it is connected with the partial positive charge containing H plus electrophile. It leads to the formation of ammonia followed by HCl. Similarly, if we go for the reactions of phosphorus trichloride, trend reverse here, because chlorine is more electronegative, phosphorus is less electronegative. So therefore phosphorus goes for the nucleophile OH minus. Similarly, chloride goes for the electrophile H plus, thus it leads to the formation of HCl followed by what? Phosphorus acid H3PO3. Similarly, arsenic trichloride, arsenic trichloride undergoes hydrolysis and forms arsenic trihydroxide. Whereas that is unstable and it loses water molecule and it is converted to arsenic oxide AS2O3. Similarly, this antimony and the bismuth trichlorides undergoes partial hydrolysis. They are not having ability to undergo complete hydrolysis. Some of the bonds are replaced by water molecules related nucleophile OH minus, but that is also unstable and loses water molecule and it is converted to SBOCl. Similarly, BiOCl, bismuth oxychloride, antimony oxychloride formation takes place. These two are examples for partial hydrolysis. These two participates in partial hydrolysis, whereas remaining participates in complete hydrolysis. Whereas arsenic acid is unstable and it is converted to arsenic oxide. This is phosphorus acid and this is ammonia. This is antimonial oxychloride. This is bismuth oxychloride formation takes place. The next is general discussion over the pentahalides of the 50A group elements. As I discussed in the early, the pentahalides formed by the 50A group elements are phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth are eligible, but not the nitrogen because it is not having any kind of d orbitals for the promotion of lone pair of electrons to make it as unpaired electron. So therefore nitrogen does not form any kind of pentahalides. Phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth all forms fluorides, whereas phosphorus, arsenic, antimony forms chlorides. Bromide is just formed by the phosphorus. These are the possible all varieties of pentahalides. By number, these are of what? 18 number. Pentahalides are more covalent than the corresponding trihalides because as per the Fasan's rule is considered, pentahalide, the central metal atom, central atom is having plus pi is the oxidation state. As it maintains plus pi, the size decreases. Moreover, its charge increases, its polarization power increases. As its polarization power increases, it withdraws the back, makes the electron density towards itself from the anion. As a result, it represents the covalent character. Regaining of electron density from the anion is possible. Thus, it attains more covalent character. Thus, the pentahalides are more covalent in nature compared to the trihalides. Suppose bismuth trifluoride is there, bismuth pentafluoride is there. Out of these two, bismuth pentafluoride is more covalent and bismuth trifluoride is less covalent, but officially it is known as bismuth trifluoride is ionic, bismuth pentafluoride is covalent. Stability also, if you go for the stability of different varieties of the pentahalides, yes, if I go for the phosphorus pentahalides to bismuth pentahalides, the stability goes on decreasing because size mismatch, cation size, anion size difference will be lot. So, net overlapping area of the orbitals will be little. As a result, the stability goes on decreasing. That's what we can see. The pentahalides formed by phosphorus are 3 in number, whereas bismuth is 1 in number and remaining 2 are 2 in number because size difference is a lot. As being both are of bigger in size and size difference is a lot implies what? Their formation becomes difficult. So, therefore, their stability decreases from top to bottom. Similarly, the hybridization related to the pentahalides as per the N value 5 plus 5 by 2. This is group number of central metal atom plus number of monovalent atoms by 2. Overall 5. 5 out of 5 forms the 5 sigma bonds sp3d. AB5 type of hybridization it is maintaining. So therefore it is trigonal bipyramidal. It is a regular structure. The meaning is 3 atoms are present on the plane along with the central atom. And remaining 2 are present. 1 is top and 1 is bottom. This is said to be trigonal bipyramidal structure. And thermal stability of trihalides is greater compared to pentahalides because this is trigonal bipyramidal, maintains unequal bond lengths for the axial bonds. So therefore, due to this disturbance, it deviates from the regularity. On heating, it is converted to phosphorus trichloride followed by chlorine implies what? It is unstable thermally. On heating, it is decomposed to most stable compound. Covalent and the ionic character, if you look at, yes, in gaseous state, they appears to be covalent in nature, but whereas in solid state, it is present in the form of cation and anionic combinations, that it is associated with ionic character with it. Suppose PCl5 in gaseous state, it is a molecule, covalent molecule, whereas in solid state, it is present as a cationic species, PCl4 plus, and an anionic species, PCl6 minus. PCl4 plus PCl6 minus, two varieties of ions combination it is maintaining. It is tetrahedral in geometry, whereas it is octahedral in geometry. Similarly, PBr5 is present in the form of PBr4 plus followed by Br minus in solid state. The These are also acting as Lewis acids. Not all, some of them are acting as Lewis acids, that whichever are having higher electronegativity and whichever are connected to more electronegative halogen are acting as Lewis acids. The observed example, the generally observed example for the Lewis acidity is phosphorus pentafluoride on reaction with F minus. Once again it forms PF6 minus. In this case it is acting as Lewis acid. This is general discussion over the phosphorus, general discussion over the pentahalides of the 50A group elements. Now we will go in exclusive discussion of the important halides, that is phosphorus halides, and those are chlorates, that is phosphorus trichloride as well as the phosphorus pentachloride. Yes, the next discussion is phosphorus trichloride. Phosphorus trichloride is PCl3, whereas phosphorus is having lone pair, where its hybridization and all the things are discussed. Whereas hybridization is, that is sp3 hybridization, and it belongs to the category of ab3e1 category, that is pyramidal geometry. Let us go for preparations. Phosphorus on reaction with limited amount of chlorine, phosphorus trichloride formation takes place. Whereas excess amount of chlorine, if it is used, then it leads to the formation of another compound, that is phosphorus pentachloride. So to avoid the formation of phosphorus pentachloride, limited amount, equivalent amount of chlorine is used, that is phosphorus plus chlorine leads to the formation of phosphorus trichloride. This reaction is a redox reaction. Phosphorus with zero oxidation state is converted to +3 state, chlorine elemental state. Zero oxidation state is converted to minus oxidation state, hence it is oxidation and the reduction combination, hence it is redox reaction. You can go for this one. 3 chlorine atoms are required and 1 phosphorus atom is required. As per that, you can get the balanced equation also. Second one is, another one best chlorinating agent is thiamine chloride, SOCl2. The structure of SOCl2 is like this. Sulfur connected with 2 chlorines with 1 double bonded oxygen is said to be thiamine chloride. It is one of the best chlorinating agent. Yes, phosphorus on reaction with thionite chloride also, this phosphorus trichloride formation takes place. Thus, phosphorus trichloride formation takes place. Phosphorus zero state is converted to phosphorus +3 oxidation. Subsequent reduction is also expected. Yes, that reduction product is sulfur chloride, disulfur dichloride, otherwise sulfur monochloride we can say. This is sulfur chloride formation takes place. Here sulfur is having -1 as the oxidation state. Yes, sulfur here +4 oxidation state is converted to -1 as oxidation state. Hence it is reduction process. So sorry, chlorine is electronegative, sulfur is of +1 oxidation state. Hence it is reduction process. In that process, to make the reaction to move in the forward direction, the driving force is entropy enhancement. That entropy enhancement is possible with the formation of sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is a gas. Due to formation of this sulfur dioxide gas, entropy of the system increases. That makes the system with the delta G negative works as a driving force to make the reaction occur in the forward direction. Thus, by phosphorus with chlorine or phosphorus with thionite chloride, phosphorus trichloride preparation can be done. And the properties is, phosphorus trichloride is a fuming liquid having boiling point of 75 degrees centigrade. So it fumes, a liquid which is always present in the more volatile, easily convertible to the vapor state, and it always produces vapor, since it is said to be fuming liquid and it is having pungent odor. Whereas it violently reacts with the water, because PO bond is strong bond compared to PCl bond. So therefore it violently reacts with the water. On reaction with water, chlorine atoms are replaced by electronegative element, nucleophile of water, that is OH-, that is POH3, phosphorus acid reaction, phosphorus acid formation takes place. The structure of phosphorus acid is, that is POH3, H3PO3, that is phosphorus acid formation takes place. I will write the structure. In this reaction, oxidation numbers of all the entities remains the same, hence it is non-redox reaction. But in this reaction, what happens? This part is connected with some portion of the water, hence it is double displacement reaction. It is double displacement, non-redox reaction. There is no oxidation, there is no reduction. Similarly, reaction with sulfuric acid. sulfuric acid with sulfuric acid vigorously it will reacts. PCl3 is also acting as a chlorinating agent, hence one of the OH bond is replaced by the chlorine, that is chlorosulfonic acid formation takes place. This is chlorosulfonic acid. In the formation of chlorosulfonic acid, there is no change in oxidation number, no oxidation and no reduction. But here this PCl3 undergoes oxidation to form P2O5 phosphorus pentoxide. Similarly, sulfur of plus 6 oxidation undergoes reduction and forms the sulfur dioxide, thus HCl and the water molecule formation takes place. Here this plus 3 oxidation state is converted to plus 5 oxidation state. Similarly, here this plus 6 oxidation state is converted to plus 4 oxidation state, thus it is a redox reaction. Once again, entropy enhancement is possible with the formation of sulfur dioxide. Thus, sulfuric acid on reaction with phosphorus trichloride, chlorosulfonic acid formation takes place. Along with this, oxidation reduction occurs. Oxidation occurs in case of what? Phosphorus, because it is having the chance to enhance the oxidation number, because it is maintaining 3. It converts to higher oxidation state, that is phosphorus pentoxide. Similarly, reduction occurs in the case of sulfur, because it is maintaining highest from the beginning, it reduces to sulfur dioxide. Thus, it leads to the formation of P2O5, sulfur dioxide, and the spectator ions combination gives HCl followed by water molecules. These are the certain chemical reactions of the phosphorus trichloride. Phosphorus acid formation, POH thrice, whichever is formed is unstable. And here phosphorus is maintaining lone pair of electrons and at the same time it is having vacant orbitals. So not having of equally distributed OHS, 3 OHS, generally want to maintain 120 degrees. But having of lone pair of electrons, there exists a lot of repulsions. That's what it want to deviate from the square planar structure. Thus, this OH bond is broken in favor of oxygen and it is making connectivity with the vacant orbital of the phosphorus. Thus, double bond formation takes place. Thus, H plus recombines with D in the form of D2 bond. Here you can expect a D2 bond from here to here. Here you can expect a D2 bond from this lone pair to this particular H plus. Thus, a new two D2 bonds combination occurs and that leads to the formation of phosphorus acid, that is H3PO3, that is phosphorus acid. Thus, phosphorus acid formation takes place. Yes, some other important reactions of the phosphorus trichloride. Phosphorus trichloride is acting as a good chlorinating agent. So it also reacts with the compounds consisting of replaceable groups like OHS. Those OHS are replaced by the chloride atom. So therefore, this phosphorus trichloride on reaction with the compounds containing of OH groups, that OH group is replaced by the chlorine. Suppose ethyl alcohol is taken, that is converted to ethyl chloride. Acetic acid is taken, acids are converted to acid halides, that is acetyl chloride formation takes place. Benzene sulfonic acid is taken, benzene sulfonyl chloride formation takes place. Thus, OH present over here is replaced by nucleophilically substituted by Cl- of the PCl3. Thus, ethyl alcohol is converted to ethyl chloride. Similarly, acetic acid is converted to acetyl chloride. Benzene sulfonic acid is converted to benzene sulfonyl chloride. It is also acting as good chlorinating agent. Thus, it adds chlorine to the system. Otherwise, it also reacts with the chlorinating agents also, because it is having expandable valency. It can form phosphorus pentachloride with higher oxidation number. The best chlorinating agents are, chlorine itself is a chlorinating agent, and the sulfur monochloride, otherwise disulfur dichloride, is also chlorinating agent. Thionyl chloride SOCl2 is also a chlorinating agent. Sulfuryl chloride SO2Cl2 is also acting as the chlorinating agent. On reaction with chlorine, nothing but what? Excess amount of chloride. That is, phosphorus on reaction with excess chlorine, phosphorus pentachloride formation takes place. Similarly, here phosphorus trichloride reaction with the sulfur monochloride. Here what happens is phosphorus pentachloride formation takes place, and similarly here thiophosphorus trichloride formation takes place, whereas the structure of this one is like this, P double bond S followed by Cl Cl and Cl. This is the structure for the thiophosphorus trichloride. And the next one is, that is sulfuryl chloride, which is acting as good chlorinating agent, whereas on reaction with this it participates in redox reaction, whereas this plus 6 oxidation number is converted to plus 4 oxidation number, whereas this plus 3 oxidation number is converted to plus 5 oxidation number. It is an example for what? Redox reaction. Similar than reaction with thionyl chloride, here what happens is, this chlorine is connected with this one, converted to phosphorus pentachloride, oxygen connected with this one, that is oxyphosphorus trichloride formation takes place, sulfur combines with this one, and thio instead of oxy, thio phosphorus trichloride formation takes place. Similarly, on oxidation also it can participate in reactions. The good oxidizing agents, oxygen, ozone, sulfur trioxide, etc., because sulfur trioxide is also acting as source of oxygen, entropy remains same, oxygen evolution takes place, entropy increases, thus it is also good oxidizing agent. On reaction with oxygen, it is converted to phosphorus oxychloride. On reaction with ozone also, the total oxygen is consumed to form phosphorus oxytrichloride. Similarly, on reaction with sulfur trioxide, it leads to the formation of sulfur dioxide plus POCl3. Similarly, it is also reacts with the Lewis acids, because it is having lone pair of electrons. As we said in the beginning, phosphorus halides are acting as Lewis bases. So therefore, on reaction with Lewis acids, adduct formation takes place. BBr3, boron tribromide. Bromine is good electron withdrawing group, more electronegative. So therefore, boron is deficient from the beginning, deficiency enhanced over there, and that particular deficiency is fulfilled by the lone pair of electrons present on the phosphorus in such a way that it leads to the formation of adduct. Similarly, on reaction with oxalic acid reaction is a special reaction, because oxalic acid on combination with the phosphorus trichloride, that goes into the formation of carbon monoxide and the carbon dioxide. Once suppose carbon monoxide formation takes place and the carbon dioxide formation takes place, here entropy of the system increases, that makes the reaction to move in the forward direction. Yes, I am making this one once again to your prime notice. It is very clear that when oxalic acid is involved in chemical transformations, oxalic acid is converted to carbon monoxide gas and carbon dioxide gas. Both are gases. Entropy of the system increases. If this process continues, the leftover system is nothing but water. That water reacts with the phosphorus trichloride, and that leads to the formation of phosphoric acid, that is H3PO3 formation takes place, and the hydrogen, extra hydrogen and the chlorine recombines, spectator ions, and leads to the formation of HCl. Even it readily combines with the metals, electropositive, less electropositive and more electropositive metals also, suppose sodium. On reaction with sodium, phosphorus readily combines with the sodium, as well as chlorine readily combines with the sodium, because we are familiar with the sodium chloride. That is, sodium phosphate followed by sodium chloride formation takes place. In both the cases, sodium is acting as electropositive. Whereas on reaction with less electropositive metals like silver, in that case what happens is that silver phosphate formation takes place, followed by phosphorus is formed over here. Here it is maintaining minus oxidation state, and here it is maintaining zero oxidation state. Whereas this is of what? Minus 1. Silver is maintaining plus 1 implies phosphorus is maintaining minus the oxidation state, and phosphorus is maintaining zero oxidation state. If I write once again, this is PCl3. This PCl3 and reaction with the silver, it leads to the formation of silver phosphide followed by phosphorus. Thus, in the last case, when phosphorus trichloride is allowed to react with the silver, silver is less electropositive, it readily combines with the more electronegative element. That more electronegative element in between these two is chlorine. Silver chloride formation takes place, and phosphorus is converted to elemental phosphorus, that is P4O. This minus 3 oxidation state is converted to 0, that is an oxidation process. Silver 0 is converted to silver plus, that is oxidation process once again. Whereas chlorine minus 3 is converted to Cl minus, hence it is an example for Thus, in PCl3 of phosphorus plus 3 state is converted to 0 state, that is reduction, whereas silver 0 is converted to silver plus, this is an oxidation. Overall here what? Oxidation and reduction reaction occurs, that is what? Redox reaction takes place. Here the more electronegative element of phosphorus trichloride combines with the silver, but the less electronegative element, relatively less electronegative element remains as it is, it not readily combines with the less electropositive metals like silver, but whereas more electropositive like sodium combines with the phosphorus and leads to the formation of sodium phosphate. Thus, it readily combines with many of the things. It can replace OH, it can react with the chlorinating agents, and also it is participates in oxidation processes. It also reacts with the Lewis acids, a special reaction with the oxalic acid followed by reaction with metals like sodium and the silver, or the cases related to the phosphorus trichloride as a reagent. Structure, already discussed for many times, structure is similar to that of ammonia, and uses, it is basically used as good chlorinating agent and also used to prepare other organic compounds. Phosphorus pentachloride, the formula is PCl5. Preparations, it can be either prepared from by directly taking phosphorus as the starting material, otherwise by taking phosphorus trichloride as the starting material. These on reaction with chlorinating agents like chlorine or sulfur monochloride, otherwise thionyl chloride, otherwise sulfuryl chloride, SOCl2. Such kind of starting materials are taken, such kind of reagents are taken, that is phosphorus followed by these of all things, or phosphorus trichloride followed by these of all things leads to the formation of phosphorus pentachloride. Suppose either phosphorus or phosphorus trichloride chlorination takes place, and that leads to the formation of PCl5. And here sulfur monochloride, in this case phosphorus pentachloride and the phosphorus thioxy trichloride formation takes place. In sulfuryl chloride case, here that leads to the formation of, that is thionyl chloride case, that leads to the formation of sulfur dioxide followed by what? Phosphorus pentachloride. Whereas in the case of sulfuryl chloride, in case of sulfuryl chloride case, sulfur dioxide formation followed by PCl5 takes place. Whereas in case of thionyl chloride case, here POCl3, PaCl3 followed by PCl5 formation takes place. So let us change this one. This is sulfuryl chloride and this is thionyl chloride, SOCl2. In case of SOCl2, we will be getting PCl5, PaCl3, that is phosphorus thioxy trichloride, phosphorus oxy trichloride formation takes place. The structures related to the things, disulfur dichloride, otherwise sulfur monochloride, is like this. And here this is thionyl chloride, SOCl2. Whereas this is sulfuryl chloride, SO2Cl2. This is thioxy phosphorus trichloride. This is like this. Sulfur dioxide everybody knows, and this one is phosphorus oxy trichloride, POCl3, is like this. You remember one thing, in case of thionyl chloride, you will be getting POCl3 followed by PsCl3 followed by what? PCl5 formation takes place. Properties related to phosphorus pentachloride, it is a white crystalline, it is a crystalline solid having pungent odor, and it is having pale yellow in color when it is pure and firm, and it is sublimes at 160 degree centigrade. On heating, it undergoes always, maintains an equilibrium with the PCl3 as well as the PCl5 with the liberation of chlorine. That's what we said in the beginning, that stability of the pentahalides is little compared to trihalides, because pentahalide is converted to trihalide, this is more stable compared to pentahalide. On reaction with water, generally on reaction with water, what happens is with excess amount of water that it leads to the formation of phosphoric acid H3PO4. With limited supply of water, it leads to the formation of phosphorus oxy trichloride, POCl3 formation takes place. Let us go for the mechanism, that what is going to be happening. Here I will write, see, here this is phosphorus pentachloride, PCl5, trigonal bipyramidal structure. Whereas on reaction with water, what happens is The Cl minus atoms are replaced by the OH minus. In the beginning, two atoms are replaced because limited amount we are adding, and those are equatorial atoms. Suppose if I take, these are present as it is. So whatever the equatorial atoms are there as it is, the axial atoms will be replaced. So therefore, this is one OH, this is one OH, and remaining three are what? Equatorial chlorines. But this is unstable compared to the chlorines, and here elimination of water molecule takes place. Thus, it leads to the formation of P double bond O, Cl and Cl. Phosphorus oxytrichloride formation takes place, and further hydrolysis, these of all are replaced by OH molecules of water, that is H3PO4 formation takes place, that is known as phosphoric acid. The other reactions with the phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride readily combines just like a phosphorus trichloride with the OH groups containing molecules, that is ethyl alcohol it is converted to ethyl chloride, acetic acid it is converted to acetyl chloride, chlorosulfonic acid is converted to chlorosulfonyl chloride, similarly even sulfuric acid is converted to sulfuryl chloride. Here these two OHs are replaced by chlorine. Nitric acid is also converted to chloronitric acid, OH is replaced by chlorine. And in these, the subsequent byproducts formed are phosphorus oxytrichloride, phosphorus oxytrichloride formation takes place. It also reacts with the phosphorus pentoxide. On reaction with phosphorus pentoxide, phosphorus oxytrichloride formation takes place. On reaction with phosphorus thiopentoxide, it leads to the formation of phosphorus thioxytrichloride formation takes place. Even it readily combines with the sulfur dioxide. On reaction with sulfur dioxide, it leads to the formation of phosphorus oxytrichloride. One oxygen is combined with the phosphorus trichloride. Remaining two chlorines combines with the SO, that is thionyl chloride formation takes place. SOCl2 formation takes place. Similarly, as I said in the beginning, it is also acting as Lewis acid because it is having vacant orbitals, and at the same time, as being it is acting as Lewis acid, electron pair acceptor, here on reaction with the BCl3, NBCl4 also chemical reactions takes place. Yes, this phosphorus pentachloride, it is not having lone pair of electrons, so it can't donate the lone pair of electrons. But it can accept the lone pair of electrons since it is acting as Lewis acid. But if any more electron deficient species comes nearer to that of phosphorus pentachloride like system, it can give one of the ligand, one of the chlorine in the form of chloride ion as a ligand out. Thus it readily combines with the Lewis acids also, but not in maximum number. Boron trichloride, it readily combines and forms PCl4+ followed by BCl4-. Similarly, niobium tetrachloride also readily combines with the phosphorus pentachloride. Here it is donating Cl- to that, and it is converted as PCl4+ followed by niobium Cl5-. Similarly, it is also acting as Lewis acid also. Yes, whenever KF like substances, potassium fluoride, K+ and F-, it readily combines with the KF, and all chlorines are replaced by the Cl-s are replaced by the F-. And it takes extra F, as a result PF6- formation takes place. That PF6- is counterbalanced by the potassium once again. That is K PF6- formation takes place. This is K+ and this is F6-, and in this KCl formation takes place. It is good chlorinating agent, and it readily combines with the metals and forms the corresponding metal halides, metal chlorides. Zinc, cadmium, platinum, RM on reaction with the phosphorus pentachloride is converted to phosphorus trichloride followed by corresponding halides, zinc chloride, similarly here cadmium chloride, platinum chloride, RM chloride formation takes place. Thus, it readily combines with the OH containing groups, combines with the phosphorus pentoxide, phosphorus thiopentoxide, readily combines with the sulfur dioxide, even it readily combines with the Lewis acid, a special case by donating Cl-. Even it readily combines with the F- by accepting the extra F- also. It readily combines with the metals and forms the corresponding metal chlorides. structure of the phosphorus pentachloride, as we discussed in the last cases or the last sessions. Here it is maintaining N is equal to what here? 5 plus 5 by 2, that is equal to 5. 5 implies it is sp3d hybridization. Hybridization is sp3d and it belongs to the category of AB5, that is trigonal bipyramidal is the structure. Phosphorus connected with the 5 chlorines, 3 chlorines are present on the plane, 2 are present, 1 is above out of 2 and other is present below the plane, and these 3 chlorines are connected with the phosphorus. I am indicating that these are present in plane like this, whereas those are equatorial and equatorial bond length is smaller and that is equal to 202 picometers, whereas axial bond length is higher and it is equal to 240 picometers. It is present in this particular molecular state in vapor and it undergoes sublimation, hence there is no liquid state. Whereas in solid state, from the X-ray analysis, it was found that it is not present as a covalent molecule, it is present as a crystalline solid molecule in which PCl 4 plus followed by PCl 6 minus is present. PCl 4 plus is tetrahedral in geometry and PCl 6 minus is having octahedral in geometry. Thus tetrahedral units and the octahedral anion, tetrahedral cation combination is present for the PCl 5 in solid state. And the basic use of this particular PCl 5 is, it is used as a good chlorinating agent, as we discussed in the former classes, that is OHS are replaced by chlorine with the help of PCl 5, and many of the cases acid is converted to acid halide. Thus many of the cases to prepare the chlorides and to replace the other nucleophiles with the Cl minus, PCl 5 used, and it is known as a best chlorinating agent in the laboratory. Some useful oxides of the 5th group elements. There are important oxides. One is bismuthyl oxychloride, otherwise bismuth oxychloride. This is possible when bismuth chloride undergoes hydrolysis. That hydrolysis is partial hydrolysis. Due to that partial hydrolysis, the formed compound is bismuth oxychloride. That is used in cosmetics and it is also known as what? Perlmite. And another one important halide of the 5th group is antimony trifluoride. Antimony trifluoride is known as Schwartz reagent and it is used as a fluorinating agent in organic chemistry. To prepare alkyl fluorides, we will use this reagent, and this reagent is consisting antimony trifluoride, which is known as Schwartz reagent, used for the fluorination of the organic compounds. Thus bismuthyl oxychloride, perlmite, and the antimony trifluoride is known as Schwartz reagents related to the 5th group important halides used here or there as reagents or in cosmetics. Important halides of the 5th group are like that.